Hello everyone, I am Gauri Sharma, guide Gauri Sharma from Carmel Convent, and I'm going to give you the information about pen knife or a dagger, screwdriver, plier and hammer, their uses and safety measures while you're using them. So let's start with pen knife. Pocket knife is a scout guide staple and a must have for any camper. Since you never know when you will need a small tool while in the middle of nowhere, it is best if you carry a pocket knife with you on your camping. This is a safety knife. Is when you're camping, you can use it for you can use it for splitting kindles, assisting with food preparation like cutting vegetables or meat. If there's fire starting and maintenance, you can use it for cutting, for making the wood sharp or for making the shape of the wood the way you want it for the fire starting. And this whittling net tent stacks, you can use it for the while you're using them. You can use the pen knife while you're making the stands for the tent stack. You can use it for if you want to make a roasting stick while you're camping and you have fire. You can use a wooden stick. You can make a wooden stick out of using this pen knife out of a wood. A roasting stick. Safety measures while you're using a pen knife. When you're using a pen knife, make sure you have a safety circle around you. Make a safety circle around you. It is important that no one come close enough and gets hurt. Do this by holding out the closed knife at arm's length and spinning it around. It's important to find enough room to work with it. Otherwise, you're putting everybody else into danger. The safest way to carve something with it is to cut away from while you're holding the knife as tightly as possible. Always use your dominant hand. Like I am a righty, so I'm going to use my right hand while I'm going to use the pen knife. And make sure while you're opening it, you open it on an arm length. Almost all pocket knives have blades that can be folded, which provides safety handles. Opening and closing this object can be dangerous and challenging, and that's why it should always be done properly. First, grip it with your non-dominant hand. Like as I said, I'm a righty, so I'm going to use my while I'm going to open it. So while I'm holding it to use it. And I need to open it, I need to use my left hand. And use the thumbnail of your other hand. Use the thumbnail of your other hand to pull the blade out. Make sure that the blade does not snap back into its place as it could hurt you. Then hold the thick part of the blade and pull it until it's fully out of the case. To close the blade, just do this process in reverse. Grip the base of your non-dominant hand. Use the dominant one to close it. Carefully hold the thick part of the blade and push it back into the case. Every time you're about to pass the tool to someone else, don't forget to close it. But if you have to do it while the blade is open, there's a proper way to do it. The person who passes the knife must hold it by its blade and the blade cutting edge to the face away from the person's hands. The person who will receive it has to take it by the handle. Once the person takes the handle, he should acknowledge the giver and he can let it go. It's important to take care of your pocket knife. A well-maintained pocket knife is not only more useful, but also a lot safer. One of the most important safety practice is sharpening it on a regular basis. A dull knife needs a lot of force to be able to cut through things. And this means it is more likely to slip and hurt you. Don't forget to keep it dry and clean. And to clean the blade before you decide to put the knife away. Finally, you should lubricate the knife's hinge whenever you can, using the appropriate oil. If you notice that the blade of your knife is wobbly, you have to have it repaired or buy another model. Even though the pocket knives are versatile tools, don't use them for things they are not designed for. Never use your knife for praying, as the blade could snap and easily hurt you or someone else in your vicinity. By following these rules, you can always use your pocket knife in a safe way without hurting yourself or somebody else.
Keeping the angle down pat. You have to keep a consistent angle all the time. And for pocket knives, they recommend having an angle about 10 to 15 degrees. So what I would do is lay your knife blade flat on the stone like that, and then lift it up till you get about 10 to 15 degrees. And what you're going to do is just going to take a nice even stroke across the surface of the stone. And as you get near the edge, you're going to kind of twist the knife out so you get the edge near the point. And you're going to repeat that. And you know you're doing it right because it sounds nice and clean when you're sharpening. Now, if it sounds like that, you know you're not doing it right. So do this about 6 times. Well, after you've done the 6th time, you're going to flip it around and do it the other way. Sharpen the other side of the blade. So again, lay it flat. Raise it up about 10, 15 degrees. And bring it around the other way. Again, twist the knife a little bit at the end so you get the edge sharpened near the point. What I like to do after I've done that is I like to go back again and just take alternating strokes. Make sure you get that bevel on your blade nice and even. Now there's a lot of debate amongst knife sharpeners whether you should push into the stone or you should go away. I think it's a choice of preference. I prefer to do it this way. They both work. So after you've done that, you're going to want to flip the stone over to the finer grit stone so you can really fine tune and get that nice sharp edge on your blade. So again, you want to prep it with the oil. And you're just going to do the same thing over again. About 6 strokes. And depending on how dull your blade is, you probably have to do this several times. Put some elbow grease into it to really get a nice sharp blade. And again, I like to finish off by doing the alternating strokes. Make sure you get that nice even bevel. All right, so we'll clean that blade off. And that's all there is to it. It's not much. Again, there's different
screwdriver and plier and hammer. So now we're going to do with screwdriver. Screwdriver tool, usually hand operated, for turning screws with slotted heads. For screws with straight diameter, slot cut across the head, standard screwdrivers with flat blade tips and a variety of sizes are used. Special screws with cross-shaped slots in their head require a special screwdriver with a blade tip that fits the slot. Safety measures while you're using a screwdriver. Do not use a screwdriver as a punch, wedge, hinge bar, or prey. Keep the tip clean and sharp to permit a solid grip on the tip of the screw. Keep the handle of the screwdriver clean and intact to allow for a solid grip. Never hold the piece you are working on in your hand. Always lay it on a workbench or place it is in vice. Carry screwdrivers in toolboxes or work belts when never in your pocket. In woods and sheet metals, make a pilot hole for the screws. Never use a screwdriver during electric work used unless it is properly isolated. Now, uses of plier and hammer. Pliers are used in various shapes and sizes and for many uses. Some are used for gripping something around like a pipe or rod. Some are used for twisting wires, and others are used for including cutting wires. So just to differentiate between if I am mentioning hammer or plier, I have differentiated the colors. For hammer, I've used a different color, and for a plier, I've used black. Safety guidelines while you're using a plier. Wear safety glasses or goggles or a face shield with safety glasses or goggles. Whenever there is a potential hazard for flying particles, wires, pieces of wire, etc. Cut at right angle. Never rock the cutting tool from side to side or bend wires back and forth against the cutting edge. Choose pliers or wire cuttings that have a grip span of 6 cm to 9 cm, that is 31.2 inches, to prevent your palm or fingers from being pinched from the tools are closed. Use adjustable pliers that allow you to grip the workpiece firmly while maintaining a comfortable hand grip, that is, hand grasp is not too wide. Use tools only if they are in good condition. Make sure that the cutting edge are sharp. Dull and worn down cutting edge may require many time more force needed for cutting. Make sure that toothed jaws are clean and sharp. Grease or worn down jaws are required in compressed safety. After such tools also require increased force to hold the workpiece, which in turn increases the risk of muscular fatigue and respective strain injuries. Oil pliers, wire cutting regularly. A drop of oil on the hinge will make the tool easier to use. Pull on the plier, do not push away from you when using pressure. If the tool slips unexpectedly, you may lose your balance or hit your hand against equipment or something else hard that may result in an injury. Select a hammer that is comfortable for you and that is the proper size and weight for the job. Misuse can cause the striking face to chip, possibly causing a serious injury. Choose a hammer with striking face. Strike a hammer blow square with the striking face parallel to the surface being stuck. Always avoid throwing blows or over and under strikes. Hammers with belt faces are less likely to chip or spell. Look behind and above while swinging the hammer. Keep enough clearance from fellow workers. Maintain a secure footing and keep good balance while using a hammer.